हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू? कैसे हैं आप लोग? राइट, गुड इवनिंग जगदीश, गुड इवनिंग डियर. राइट, नाउ इट्स टाइम टू डिस्कस. प्रकाश, हेलो. नाउ इट्स टाइम टू डिस्कस द सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन पार्ट टू. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस the satellite communication part 1 and now it's time to discuss the satellite communication part 2. Right, mainly in this discussion we are going to solve some question related to the power, and after that the some question related to what the uplink and downlink, right? And after that the carrier to noise ratio, that is called C by N ratio, we have to calculate. Right, new join sir. Okay Jagdish, that's great. Mathi, Smriti, hello sir, hello, hello dear everyone. Now, that is basically all about me. My name is Chandan Jha, right? 9+ of year experience. Apart from the teaching, I am also taking the motivational session, right? And I have taken the motivational session in various engineering colleges, including NITs and some IITs. My area of expertise is digital electronics, control system, signal system, and communication and microprocessor, right? Suruchi, good evening. Now there will be 20 days left for the gate, right? Now it's time to discuss about the ISRO, that is called satellite, that is not radar actually, it is a satellite, right? Revision class for the satellite. Now for the satellite, that is the link analysis I'm going to discuss. In the link analysis, there will be the one transmitter, it is a transmitter, right? And the satellite, there will be the receiver. And after, then when the signal is received, then that signal is again transmitted to the earth station, then the satellite behaves as a what? At the time, that is a transmitter, and earth station will behave as a what? That is a receiver. Ye receiver ki tarah behave karta hai. Good evening, right? Ram Suri, good morning, good evening dear. Hamesha ek cheez dhyan rakhiyega, the most important thing for the satellite communication. In the satellite, generally we are using the FM modulation, right? General, that is frequency modulation. We are generally using, sir, ISRO exam, which date 12th of Jan, 12 January, right? 12 January ko Madhu, that is the 12th of Jan. Right now, for the satellite communication, we generally use what? FM modulation. Why FM modulation is used? Because in the FM modulation, the less power is required to transmit, right? So FM in the, because in the frequency modulation, what is the frequency modulation? The carrier or frequency of the carrier changes with respect to instantaneous amplitude of the message signal. So in the resultant signal, there will be the only carrier amplitude of the carrier is fixed. So if the amplitude of the carrier is fixed, so the power is closely related to what? The amplitude of the signal. Power sirf amplitude signal se related hai, right? So it is called uplink or downlink. To transmit the signal, it is called uplink, it is called uplink, and it is called downlink. It is called uplink and it is called downlink, right? Ananya, are you getting my point? Sorry, not Ananya, Aishwarya. Ananya, how much marks do satellite communication hold in this row? Sabse khas baat ek cheez bata dun. I have observed the last year, last 10 year of the paper. 10 year of the ISRO paper. 10 year ISRO paper. Right? And जो मैंने इंटरव्यू और दूसरे जो स्टूडेंट जो लोगों ने मेरे जो इंटरव्यू दिए हैं आफ्टर द ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ दैट आई फील फॉर द रिटर्न स्पेशली दे जनरली आस्क अबाउट सी बाय एन राइट दैट इज कॉल्ड करियर टू नॉइज रेशियो जनरली द क्वेश्चन विल बी एंड द सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल बी रिलेटेड टू पावर राइट दीज टू टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन जनरली दे विल आस्क इन द एवरी पेपर वन और टू क्वेश्चन वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट और वी कैन से द टू क्वेश्चन और थ्री क्वेश्चन वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम द सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन राइट Right now. Now we can say that FM modulation technique we can use for the what? For the satellite communication. In the technique, the power is same as the carrier. We know that for the FM, the power is same as the carrier power. When compared to the modulation, the technique FM required less power. For the all other, if we are comparing the FM with the all other of the modulation, then it will require the less power, right? Now, that is for the power analysis. For the power analysis, that is the most important thing. Just remember, this one is the important, right? अगर आप एंटीना भी पढ़ेंगे तो ध्यान रखिएगा, एंटीना के लिए फॉर द पावर कैलकुलेशन दिस टाइप ऑफ फॉर्मूला इज एसेंशियली रिक्वायर्ड. सो जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला. सो आई एम जस्ट ट्रांसमिटिंग, देयर विल बी द ट्रांसमीटर, राइट, इन द अर्थ स्टेशन देयर विल बी द ट्रांसमीटर, एंड ट्रांसमीटर हैविंग द गेन दैट इज कॉल्ड जी ऑफ टी, एंड ट्रांसमीटर विल रेडिएट्स द पावर दैट इज कॉल्ड पी ऑफ टी. सो द ट्रांसमीटर, ट्रांसमीटर हैविंग द पावर, रेडिएटिंग पावर पी टी, एंड द गेन इज जी टी, राइट. सो वी कैन से दैट इट इज अ पी टी एंड जी टी इज द टोटल पावर ट्रांसमिटेड. नाउ इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द प्लक्स फ्लक्स एट पर्टिकुलर इंस्टेंट, दैट इज द आर फ्रॉम द वॉट, दैट इज द आर फ्रॉम द ट्रांसमीटर एट द साइड, देन इट विल इन द सर्कुलर नेचर द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द सिग्नल विल डिक्रीज. हमेशा सर्कुलर नेचर में स्ट्रेंथ सिग्नल का क्या होता है, डिक्रीज करता है. Yes, Madhu is asking one question. The satellite is important in the interview. Definitely, satellite is important. Satellite, optical, analog, electronics and communication is important for the interview also, right? Now, Jagdish, I have discussed about the geostationary satellite in the previous class, right? Just look at the previous lecture. I have discussed about the geostationary orbit. Called the FRIS. Yes, 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 Aishwarya, correct. PR is called the Friis transmission formula. Right now, if so, at the particular strength R, if you want to find out what is the strength of flux density, then it will be just divide this value by R square. That is, right? So, flux density at the distance R will be what? PT into GT upon 4 pi R square. 4 pi R square. Vapas again, I repeat kar raha hu. PT GT upon 4 pi R square. PT is nothing. It is just a transmitted power. GT is nothing. It is just a transmission gain. And R is nothing. It is just a distance from the what? Distance from the transmitter. Now, power received at the antenna. Ye, I am just taking the antenna. It is an antenna, right? It is an antenna. So, always the antenna having the gain GR and it having the parameter that is called effective aperture, that is A. Effective aperture is nothing, AA is nothing, it is just A. Eta into A. A is the cross-sectional area of what antenna and eta is the efficiency of antenna, right? Now, so if you want to find here the power, what is the power received by this antenna? So, if you want to find out the what is the power received by the antenna, that is called PR. PR is nothing, it is just a PT GT upon 4 pi R square and just multiply this with the AE. AE is nothing what? That is the effective aperture, right? Now, we know that gain again, if you want to find out what is the gain of the antenna, receiving antenna, then gain of the receiving antenna is nothing, it is just a 4 pi AE upon lambda square. So, if you want to find out the AE, so A equal to GR into lambda square upon 4 pi, or we can say that GR upon 4 pi upon lambda square, we can write like this, that is called effective aperture, right? Sir, is the microprocessor more important for this? No, microprocessor is not that much more important. But yes, there will be the one or two question also from the microprocessor. That is not that much of tough question. Or but ek cheez hamesha dhyan rakhna. If there will be the tough question asked in the actually what happened in the ISRO exam. Kya hota kya ISRO mein, hamesha ek cheez ka dhyan rakhega. The solving the question is not important for the ISRO. Aapke paas 80 question hai. Aur aap 80 question ko solve kar rahe ho. Ye important role play nahi karta. Right? We are not able to solve the 80 question. Right? Entire question in the ISRO. So what happened? Aapko karna kya hai? 80 क्वेश्चन में से सबसे पहले उस क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करिए, दैट विल टेक द लेस टाइम, राइट, एंड डू नॉट रीड दैट क्वेश्चन वेरी मच, राइट. आप क्वेश्चन को बार बार पढ़ के उसको वापस एनालाइज करके क्रॉस चेक करके पूरा इतना मत करिए. जस्ट पिक द क्वेश्चन और 40 क्वेश्चन अगर आप इसमें से चेक करोगे तो 40 क्वेश्चन यू विल फील दैट इज वेरी ईजी, राइट, दैट इज वेरी ईजी. इट विल टेक अराउंड 1 मिनट to solve the question. So just solve the 40 question in the 40 minute or in the 1 hour or in the 1 hour. So if you'll solve the 40 question within the 1 hour, then the confidence will get high. Aapka confidence badh jayega. Aur 40 question karne ka matlab hota hai 120 marks you are getting, right? And that is the 100% sure shot marks. Ye 100% sure shot hona chahiye marks. But just for the remaining 40 question, just try to solve 20 question, right? इफ यू सॉल्व दैट 20 क्वेश्चन, और इसमें से मान लीजिए 5-7 क्वेश्चन ऑब्वियस हम ये मानते हैं कि गलत भी हो सकता है. सो इफ देर विल द 5 or 7 क्वेश्चन विल बी रॉन्ग, देन एटलीस्ट आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग द 12 क्वेश्चन विल बी राइट. सो देर विल बी 36, 12 + 36 दैट इज 156. 100% चांसेज है कि आपका रिटर्न निकल जाएगा. बट येस, इफ द क्वेश्चन डिफिकल्टी लेवल इज हाई, देन तब तो कुछ भी हो सकता है. तब तो ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि 50 क्वेश्चन और 50 मार्क्स से ही आपका कट ऑफ निकल जाए. सो डोंट पैनिक एट द एग्जाम टाइम, इफ डू हैव एनी डाउट. और आपको पेपर, क्योंकि हमने अगर प्रिपरेशन किया है तो हमको पेपर को देख के ये तो पता चल जाता है दैट इज अ टफ क्वेश्चन और दैट इज अ इजी क्वेश्चन. सो जब आप पेपर पढ़ेंगे और आपको फील होता है कि टफ क्वेश्चन है, तो ज्यादा टेंशन नहीं लेना, क्योंकि वो टफ क्वेश्चन सिर्फ आपके लिए नहीं है, जितने भी लोग एग्जाम देंगे उन सबके लिए वो टफ पेपर है. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट राइट नाउ. सो जस्ट जी आर आई एम राइटिंग इफेक्टिव अपर्चर दैट इज जी आर अपॉन 4π λ² आई एम जस्ट रिप्लेसिंग दैट इफेक्टिव अपर्चर द फॉर्मूला दैट इज जी आर, देन इट विल बिकम PT GT into GR अपॉन 4π r/λ². सो द फॉर्मूला विल बी, द फॉर्मूला विल बी PR = PT GT GR / 4π r/λ² एंड दैट 4π r/λ² इज कॉल्ड वन थिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड LE. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय LE? दैट इज कॉल्ड पाथ लॉस राइट. दैट इज कॉल्ड द पाथ लॉस. इट इज a path loss, right? So just remember how to calculate the path loss, but this parameter is called the path loss. It is also important, that formula, path loss. And PTGT is related to the isotropic antenna, PTGT. So I am writing PTGT is a EIRP. EIRP nothing, it is just a effective isotropically radiated power. मैं वापस से बोल दूं, that class is so for those student who are thinking to leave the satellite communication for the ISRO. So, आप अगर एक या दो दिन, अगर आप 40-45 minutes के आसपास का video होता है, within the 45 hours, लगभग कल की class और आज की class मिला दिया जाए, then that will be, I think, around 1.5 hour की class होगी. And I assure you, if there will be the 4 question, then definitely 2 or 3 question, definitely you will solve it, right? By these 1.5-2 hours की class से आप definitely उसको solve कर ही देंगे, right? Now, so EIRP, nothing, it is just a what? Effective isotropic radiated power is called EIRP, PT into GT. So I'm writing the formula, PT into GT as a EIRP, right? GR is the what? Received antenna gain, and this is the path loss. So PR, received power equal to EIRP into GR upon LE. This formula, right? And LE, what about LE? Sir, 4π r/λ² And if you want to find out this in dB, generally they will ask in dB. So in the dB, just take 10 log 10 base, ERP, EIRP into GR upon LP. Then you will get what? PR equal to ERP, that is related to transmitter. This is GR is related to gain. And all the other loss, that is the LP. Or if there is the another loss, just subtract that loss. You will get the answer. Right? Received power. And I think 4 or 5 questions will be there in the ISRO, which is related to the received power only, right? Vita, sir, के basis में cut off होता है क्या? No. There will be no this type of basis on the ISRO exam. All the other type of the losses, all the other type of losses are basically added. There is not only the branch loss, there will be the handover loss, and there will be the lots of loss is there. If there will be the loss is mentioned in the form in the question, just subtract that loss, right? So transmitter this one EIRP and GR is added, and all the other loss will be subtracted from this formula, right? Now, so again I am repeating, just remember one thing. What? Just remember the one thing. First, what is PR? EIRP into GR upon LE, right? First remember this one. What about EIRP? Sir, EIRP nothing, it is just a PT into GT. Next, what about the LE? That is 4π r/λ² right? Just remember this one. And GR is nothing, it is just a received gain, right? You all know the formula of this one, right? So just for the practice, I'm going to give you one question that is for the practice, that is not a ISRO question. After the 2 or 3 questions, will directly comes on the ISRO question. right? After the two or three question, we'll directly come into the ISRO question, right? Gopal Kumar, good evening, dear. Right? Smita, good evening. Now, just everybody just solve this question, very easy question. That is the basically the formula based question, not that much of typical question. Just solve it. Everybody just solve it, this question, right? That is only for the practice. There will be the satellite. And there will be the antenna. And satellite is transmitting the power to the what, or signal to the what? Antenna. Now, what is given in the problem? I am reading that problem for you. A satellite located at the distance of 40,000 km from a point on the Earth's surface radiates the power of 2 watt. So, there will be the given radiates power Pt equal to what? 2 watt. It will transmit the power of 2 watt. From an antenna with a gain of 17 dB, the gain of the antenna is also given, that is Gt, 17 dB. Right? Now, the effective area of the receiving antenna is, AE is given, effective area of this antenna is given, that is 10 meters square. Determine the EIRP, gain of the receiving antenna, path loss and the power received at the Earth station. And the downlink, if the downlink frequency is 11 gigahertz. Just solve this question, everybody. Sir, in the radar, there is a formula named range equation. Yes, in the radar, there will be the range equation. Right? Actually, definitely. In the radar, actually, I am not touching the radar portion here. Hum 45 minutes ki class rakhenge. And that will be the class of the radar will be shifted to the next class. So, aapke upar jyada burden bhi nahi hai. Aur aap apna kaam jis tarike se aap preparation kar rahe hain, wo preparation aap karte rahiye. Uske liye aapko jyada additional karne ki kuch zarurat nahi hai. Bas aapko ek cheez dhyan rakhne ki zarurat hai, kya? Bas us additional aapki preparation ke saath, aapko 45 minutes additionally, aapko ye session dekhiye, bina affect ke aapke class ke. Right, do not affect your class. Just solve this question. Radar ka class, live class hoga dost. In the next session, I'll discuss the radar day after tomorrow, right? Kal nahi hoga, after the parso. Yes, if there is any difference, yes, there will be the difference. There will be the only the little bit difference. There will be the two time, or we can say that there will be the two time of distance is calculated. So we have to use the divide by two for the radar. Ashwarya, yes. Now EIRP, if you are solving the EIRP, what is the answer for this? Just solve this question. EIRP. EIRP nothing, it is just a PT into GT. PT is given, GT is given, DB. Just solve this value in the normal. So GT is given in the problem 10 raised to power 1.7. So if you want to find out the GT, that is 100. Right? 100 point, that is not 100. PT, I am writing like this. EIRP. Nobody is solving this question, EIRP. Kaise hoga dost? PT into GT. PT is 2 watt. GT is 10 raised to power 1.7. I am just converting this value into what? Into normal value. That is not in dB. Ye dB mein nahi hai. That is in the normal value. Yes. Jagdish is giving the correct answer. Jagdish, excellent. That is 100.24. Ram Swarup is giving the correct answer. That is called 100 into, that answer will be the 100.2, right? That is the ERP, right? Excellent. Now for the next, gain of the receiving antenna. What is the gain of the receiving antenna? GR. You all are, maine pehle hi likh diya tha formula, 4 pi. Yaad kariyega formula. Right? ERP, question tha, that answer is not 100, that answer is 100. Yes, answer is approximately correct answer, right? Now if you will solve it, what is the formula for GR, right? Just remember one thing. For the GR, 4 pi A into what? Lambda square. 4 pi A into lambda square. So 4 pi A into lambda square. Just solve it. Everybody just solve this question. Formula is given in front of you. Rajat, correct answer. Deepika, EIRP. isotropic radiated power. Now just if you are solving this question GR, then what happened to the GR? What is the formula? And AE is also given in the problem. Lambda we can calculate by C by F. F is also given, that is 11 gigahertz, right? 11 gigahertz. Just put the value and find out the GR. Just find out the GR, everybody. If you will calculate the GR, it will comes. Yes, yes, yes. The Suruchi Sharma, your answer is correct, correct. In the dB, that will be the 52 dB. Yes, Ram Swarup, your answer is also correct. That will be 172,378. 172,378. And if in the dB, if you are calculating in dB, that is 52 point. That answer will be 52.23 dB. This answer, 52.23 dB, right? So, आपको रिसीविंग एंटीना का गेन भी पता चल गया और इट इज ऑल्सो यूजफुल फॉर द ईएमएफटी. एंटीना एंटीना बोल रहे हैं पर रिसीविंग एंटीना का गेन कैसे कैलकुलेट होगा, राइट? सो वहां पर भी विल यूज द फॉर्मूला इज सेम, देयर विल बी नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन द फॉर्मूला, राइट? ओके, द क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क्ड बाय द वंदन आंसर हाउ टू डू दिस टाइप ऑफ काइंड ऑफ सम्स विदाउट कैलसी. एनी शॉर्टकट? नो, एक्चुअली देयर विल बी नो शॉर्टकट. वी हैव टू यूज, but just take the approximation, do not do that is in the exact calculation, just do the approximation, right? Jesnas, hi sir, thank you for the classes for ECE student, God bless you. Okay, thank you. Thank you Jesna Thomas, thank you. Now if you want to find out the path loss, what is the formula for the path loss, right? LE for the path loss, just solve this question. What is the formula for the path loss? I have given that formula to you. For the path loss, nobody is going to answer. Only the 4 or 5% or 6% is going to give the answer, right? Just respond. Yes, Deepika, your answer is correct. 52 dB for this. Yes, correct answer. Micro class. After the radar, we will start the some classes of the microwave also. Or in the microwave, there will be the, I'll take around 4 to 5 hour class. In the 4 to 5 hour class, I'll focus only on those particular topic which is very, very important for the ISRO, right? So that the time will be effectively utilized. Just solve this question. Nobody is going to answer this LE. 4 pi r upon lambda. That is 4 pi r upon lambda whole square. Everything is given in the problem. What about the LE? 52 what? 205.3 dB. I'm writing directly in the dB. Everybody just respond for this. 205.3 dB. It is the answer for this, right? And now, if you want to end the power received at the earth station, what is the power received at the earth station? PR. If you want to find out, EIRP, we have to add it plus. EIRP, we have to add it plus. The gain, we have to add it minus. Path loss, we have to subtract it. Everything in the dB. Just solve this and find the PR. Just find the PR. Now that is the only the addition, addition or subtraction. Everybody just solve this question. Yes, Suruchi, your answer is correct. 205. Correct, correct, correct. Ram Sarip, LE is not 102.65 dB. That is the 205.3 dB. Once again, there will be the calculation mistake, I think. Koi dikkat nahi, calculation ko aap wapas se check kariye. Aapka aa jayega answer 205.3 dB. So just give me the power, PR. That will be in the minus, actually. That will be in the minus. Shiva Prasad, hi sir, I am late. No issues, Shava Shiva, no issues. Vikram, sir, why KE, that IE 228 dB note taking? Where is 228 dB? I am not getting your answer. Where is 228? Yes, minus. Yes, yes, yes. Now answer is correct. Everybody now give. That is not. Minus 103 point. Anu is giving the answer. Minus 103.07 dB. How that is? What about the EIRP? We have done. We have solved the EIRP. What is that? 100.2. So it is 100.2 dB. I am just writing 100.2 plus 52 dB minus 205.33. You will get what? Minus 133 point something. That is minus 133 approximately. I am writing minus 133 dB. There will be the calculation mistake. 150 तो यही हो गए और 150 में से आपके पास ओके आपने सारी चीजें कैलकुलेट कर ली ना 205.533 dB. जस्ट सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. गुड इवनिंग सर, सॉरी फॉर लेट हो गया. कोई बात नहीं समीरा, कोई दिक्कत नहीं. राइट नाउ ओके, नाउ आई एम मूविंग. दैट इज द बेसिकली द बेसिक क्वेश्चन. दैट इज द फॉर्मूला. आपको सिर्फ फॉर्मूला को याद करवाने के लिए फॉर्मूला दिया गया था, नथिंग एल्स. देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ दैट थिंग. दैट फॉर्मूला इज गिवन ओनली टू यू टू सॉल्व व्हाट, टू यूटिलाइज द मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला, टू रिमेंबर दैट मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला. एंड थ्री फॉर्मूला इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वन दैट इज जी आर, राइट, रिसीव्ड एंटीना गेन. सेकेंड वन द पाथ लॉस एल पी. एंड थर्ड वन दैट इज पी आर, रिसीव्ड पावर फॉर्मूला, राइट. दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. धनलक्ष्मी यस 40 डीबी, यस धनलक्ष्मी, गुड. कोई बात नहीं दोस्त, उसको विक्रम बाद में कर लेंगे, कोई दिक्कत नहीं. दैट इज द फॉर्मूला ना, यू ऑल आर अवेयर हाउ टू कैलकुलेट इन द डीबी, राइट. नाउ दैट इज क्वेश्चन, विल डू द सम इसरो क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो. दैट इज द एक्चुअली ये नॉर्मल क्वेश्चन थे, फॉर्मूला के लिए थे. अब हम इसके बाद विल डू सम क्वेश्चन विच इज द बेसिकली द इसरो क्वेश्चन. इसरो के प्रीवियस ईयर में आए क्वेश्चन वो देखेंगे और उसके बाद आपको पता चलेगा दैट क्वेश्चन इज नॉट दैट मच ऑफ टिपिकल क्वेश्चन. दैट इज वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली, बट यू हैव टू नो सम फॉर्मूला, सम कंसेप्ट, राइट. नाउ ओके, दैट आंसर इज करेक्ट. माइनस 105.7 इज कमिंग. ओके वशंता, कोई दिक्कत नहीं. वशंता योर आंसर इज करेक्ट. माइनस 105.07 इज कमिंग. ओके नाउ जस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, दैट इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. इस पे बेस्ड लगभग 4 to 5 क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क इन द इसरो फ्रॉम लास्ट 10 ईयर, राइट. इन द लास्ट 10 ईयर द करियर टू नॉइज रेशियो, राइट. दैट करियर इज टू नॉइज रेशियो इज नथिंग, दैट इज सी बाय एन रेशियो वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट. द करियर टू नॉइज रेशियो इज नथिंग, इट इज जस्ट ए रिसीव्ड पावर अपॉन द नॉइज पावर. एंड वी आर राइटिंग द नॉइज पावर इज के टी बी, के टी बी, राइट. B is nothing, it is a bandwidth. T is the noise temperature which is given in the problem. And K is the Boltzmann constant. K is the Boltzmann constant. And generally the problem is, they will generally ask this formula in the dB or value of C by N in dB. Always. Always. Right? So if you want to find out for what is the formula for PR, if you want to find out the formula for PR, then it is the EIRP. Into what? That is gain upon what? Path loss. So I am writing this one. I am just replacing this PR with this formula. Then we'll get this one. Right? Then we'll get this one. Now we can say that हमने कुछ भी नहीं किया दोस्त, बस PR का formula को उठाकर यहाँ पे पटक दिया. और जब आपने PR के formula को यहाँ पटक दिया, then you'll get ERP into GR upon LP K LE, that is path loss, KTEB, right? T is the noise temperature, which is always given in the problem. B is the bandwidth. K is the Boltzmann constant. GR is the received antenna gain. And EIRP is the isotropic radiated power. Now, if you want to find out the dB, then these two things are added. And the denominator, everything is subtracted. Generally, they are not giving the bandwidth in the formula. So, if you are not giving the bandwidth of the formula, just take the B as a 1 hertz. Right, if B is not given in the, consider that 1 hertz, right. Now there will be the two things, right. Just take the snapshot for this. This is useful formula, right. This is very very important. Now there will be two things, signal to noise ratio. If there is an antenna and if there is a satellite, right. So there will be the two communication will take place. One is the uplink and another one is the downlink. दो तरीके की चीजें होगी, एक अपलिंक होगा और दूसरा डाउनलिंक. There will be the one uplink and yes, Vikram. Sir, the K was taking sir 228.6 dB. Okay, dear. Which book is for the basic numerical of the suggest for the satellite or for the radar, right?
देखिए राडार के लिए तो मैं क्लास में बताऊंगा, पर द सैटेलाइट द टाइम इज वेरी शॉर्टेज राइट, सो डू नॉट गो टू द बुक और स्टैंडर्ड बुक, जस्ट रिमेंबर फ्यू फॉर्मूला राइट, जस्ट रिमेंबर फ्यू फॉर्मूला, बिकॉज अगर आप बुक में जाओगे ना तो दैट इज सैटेलाइट इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक राइट, इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट, हो सकता है कि आपको उसमें मजा आने लग जाए अगर हम वही पढ़ते चले जाए तो आपका टाइम अननेसेसरी वेस्ट हो जाएगा, सो डोंट गो थ्रू द बुक एट दिस टाइम, आपको ये पहले से जाना चाहिए था, इट्स दिस टाइम इट इज वेरी लेट बिकॉज 22 तारीख आज हो गई, दैट इज द 22 ऑफ दिसंबर, 12th तक को पेपर है, लगभग 15-20 दिन लगभग बचे हुए हैं राइट, सो डोंट गो थ्रू द बुक नाउ, सो फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट द सी बाय एन फॉर द अपलिंक, देन द सी बाय एन फॉर द डाउन लिंक, दैट इज ऑलवेज गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द ओवरऑल सिग्न ओवरऑल C by N ratio, then it will be 1 upon C by N naught equal to 1 upon C by N for uplink plus 1 upon C, that is a register in the parallel, just formula is same as the register in the parallel. So we can write C by N naught overall equal to C by N, that is in node DB, right? Is formula mein bhi DB mein nahi likhna hai. In uplink C by N in the downlink divide by C by N uplink एंड सी बाय एन फॉर द डाउन लिंक, बस ये दो चीजें मुझे बतानी थी, इसके अलावा किसी चीज की जरूरत नहीं, एवरी क्वेश्चन वी कैन डू बाय दिस फॉर्मूला ओनली, सो रिमेंबर दिस रेडिएटेड पावर एंड दिस ओवरऑल करियर टू नॉइज रेशियो, ओवरऑल करियर टू नॉइज रेशियो. थैंक यू ऐश्वर्य, कैन वी चेक एग्जाम इफ दे स्टार्ट प्रॉपरली नाउ, कैन यू, यस डेफिनेटली यार, आपने गेट के लिए तो प्रिपेयर कर ही रखा है दोस्त, वरना आर यू आर वेल प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द गेट, सो दिस इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम, जस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, जस्ट यूटिलाइज द टाइम, दैट विल गिव यू द रिजल्ट, आप इस समय को कैसे यूटिलाइज करते हैं आपका रिजल्ट उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है राइट. नाउ नाउ वी कैन से दैट जस्ट सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, वन क्वेश्चन, आफ्टर दैट विल डायरेक्टली मूव ऑन द वॉट इसरो क्वेश्चन, just solve this question. In the satellite communication system, the uplink, that is C by N ratio, is 24.5 dB, and the downlink C by N ratio is 15.4 dB. determine the overall C by N ratio. Just solve this question, very easy question, that is not that much of typical question, how to calculate C by N ratio. C by N overall equal to C by N uplink into C by N downlink upon C by N uplink plus C by N downlink. जैसे कि register को आप parallel में लगाते हैं, just like that, right? Just solve this question. Everybody, just solve this question. But first of all, this value is given in the dB. So just calculate this value in what? Just calculate this value in the normal. So if you are calculating it, it will become 10 raised to power 2.45. If you are calculating it, it will become 10 raised to power 1.54. Right? 10 raised to power 1.54, 10 raised to power 2.45. Now just solve it. 10 raised to power 2.45 into 10 raised to power 1.45 upon 10 raised to power 2.45 प्लस 10 रेज टू पावर 1.454, और इसको ज्यादा एग्जैक्ट करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बाय द अप्रोक्सीमेशन वी कैन सॉल्व. व्हाट अबाउट द वैल्यू ऑफ 10 रेज टू पावर 2.5 इफ इट इज गिवन राइट, सो इट विल बी अप्रोक्सीमेटली 281 point something, सो जस्ट टेक 281, एंड व्हाट अबाउट 10 रेज टू पावर 1.54, दैट इज 34.67. Just give me the answer for this. Everybody. Shiva Prasad, teaching good. Thank you, Shiva. 14.81 dB. Excellent. Ram Sarup is giving the correct answer. Anup is giving the correct answer. Vikram is giving the correct answer. Charan, I think you did some silly mistake. That's why, or calculation mistake. That's why otherwise your answer is correct. Mani is giving the correct answer, 14.48 dB. Yes, the answer will be 14.8 dB. Now, yes. हर्षित वर्मा आंसर करेक्ट 14.8 dB करेक्ट 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 विदाउट कैलकुलेटर देखो इतना टिपिकल नहीं आता और विदाउट कैलकुलेटर अगर पॉसिबल नहीं है तो क्वेश्चन को देख के आप पहले से एनालाइज करिए दैट क्वेश्चन इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू सॉल्व विदाउट कैलकुलेटर एंड जस्ट लीव द क्वेश्चन राइट फॉर द इसरो इट इज वेरी असेंशियल 14 सुरुचि करेक्ट 14 dB करेक्ट ऐश्वर्य दैट इज नॉट 1991 वॉट इन द dB एक्चुअली वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एंड देर इज नो रेशियो ऑफ सी बाय एन देर इज नो नो यूनिट ऑफ सी बाय एन 14.9 सुरेंद्र करेक्ट कैलकुलेटर इज नॉट देयर इन इसरो यस सुरेंद्र कैलकुलेटर इज नॉट देयर नाउ वन थिंग रिमेंबर द डिजाइन फॉर द डाउनलिंक इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट देन द अपलिंक राइट देर विल बी टू थिंग्स One is the uplink, another one is the downlink, right? One is the uplink and another one is the downlink. So, the designing of the downlink is more important than the uplink. In order to improve the C by N, that is carrier to noise ratio, the only parameter which can be varied at the earth station is GR by T. So, this is also important thing, GR upon T, and it is called FOM, figure of merit. Satellite. One question, there will be the one question that is to find out figure of merit, FOM, figure of merit. How to solve the figure of merit? Right? For figure of merit, GR upon T. T is the what? That noise temperature which is given in the problem and GR is the what? The received antenna gain. Practically, the gain of the receiving antenna should be as high as possible and T should be as minimum as possible. Obvious. Because we want to high FOM, figure of merit, right? Now just remember one thing, first is as the minimum as possible, so it is the same thing. Now we can solve this question, just take this question as a homework. Homework, to memorize the formula, ye just class khatam hote hi aapko solve karna hai ghar pe baith ke ye question, right? Just solve it. Sir, from is equal to 1 upon S by N, yes, yes, actually it is a S by N only, but in the S signal, they are transmitting the carrier. That's why I'm using carrier to noise ratio. Right? Now, just take this question as your homework. Or after that, just take the snapshot for this. Everybody, just take the snapshot. Now, that is the ISRO question. That is the ISRO question. Just solve this question. Koi alag se formula ki zarurat nahi hai. That is the same formula is required. In a telecommunication, the trans receiver system, the transmitting the antenna with the antenna aperture of 1 meter is fed with 1 watt. So aperture effect, antenna aperture is given, that is 1 meter is fed with 1 watt of the power at 10 gigahertz. At 10 gigahertz, just solve this question. The receive antenna with the antenna aperture of 0.5 meter located at 1 kilometer away receives x milliwatt power is not given right given in the problem x milliwatt of the power if the transmitting frequency changes to 20 gigahertz what will happen to receiving power what will happen to receiving power just solve this question very easy question Everybody just solve this question. Just remember one thing. Power in the power formula, there will be the 1 upon lambda. Or in the lambda, in the actually lambda in the denominator. So lambda equal to nothing, it is just a C by F. So we can say that C by F or there will be the lambda square. So the power is... basically proportional to F square. Right? Just look at the formula. There will be lambda square in the denominator, right? Now, if we know that this, then we can say that if PR1 for the first time is upon 10 gigahertz square and for the second one, PR2. What about the frequency? That is 20. Otherwise, everything is given. Not required in this problem. Not required for this problem. Yes, yes, yes. Harshit, your answer is correct. Harshit is giving the correct answer. Aditya, just check it out. Right? Now, if you want to solve this question, then it will become what? PR1 upon PR2 equal to 10 upon 20 giga giga square. Giga ne giga ko niptaya. और ये नीचे 2 आ गया तो पी आर वन अपॉन पी आर टू इक्वल टू 1/4 राइट 1/4 सो इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट देन आई एम राइटिंग पी आर टू इक्वल टू पी आर वन और 4 पी आर वन एंड नाउ इफ इन द डीबी वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग देन इट विल बिकम पी आर टू इन द डीबी इक्वल टू 10 लॉग 4 प्लस पी 10 लॉग पी आर टू So it will become nothing. It is just a what up 6.04 calculator and Kelsey in the control system. We have did many times in the body plot. Just remember. So it will become approximately 6 dB. So where is the answer? Increase by the 6 dB. B is the correct option. बाकी के जितने भी चीजें दी गई है सिर्फ आपको गुमराह करने के लिए दी गई है. No requirement for that. There is no requirement for that. Right? Everybody just respond. ऑप्शन बी ऐश्वर्य करेक्ट आंसर सुरुचि करेक्ट आंसर आदित्य करेक्ट आंसर हर्षित करेक्ट आंसर विक्रम करेक्ट आंसर नाउ जस्ट सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन द अवेलेबल पावर रिक्वायर्ड द अवेलेबल पावर रिक्वायर्ड एट द रिसीविंग एंटीना इज 10^-6 वॉट द ट्रांसमिटिंग एंड रिसीविंग एंटीना इट इज ऑल्सो इसरो क्वेश्चन ये इसरो का क्वेश्चन है राइट The transmitting and the receiving antenna have gain of 40 dB each. GT is 40 dB, GR is 40 dB, both are given. The carrier frequency is 4 GHz and the distance between them is 30 miles. The required transmitter power is, PT is required, transmitter power is required. So just first remember this. What about the PR? What about the PR? Sir, PR equal to PT into GT into GR upon path loss is also given. So I'm writing what? If you want to find out PR, write for this. Upon 4 pi D upon lambda whole square. Now if you want to find out the PT, PT is they're asking. Then PR into 4 pi D upon lambda or R. स्क्वायर अपॉन जी टी इंटू जी आर राइट जस्ट सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन और वी कैन से दैट पी टी इक्वल टू वॉट पी आर इंटू 4 पाई आर स्क्वायर अपॉन लेमडा स्क्वायर जी टी इंटू जी आर जस्ट सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन एवरीथिंग इज गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम पुट द फॉर्मूला एंड राइट द वैल्यू It is also ISRO question. But that is the basically very typical question. Again, मेरे time में सही बता रहा हूँ अगर ये question होता मेरे time में अगर ये question होता तो formula याद होने के बाद भी मैं कभी solve नहीं करता Why मैं कभी इसको क्यों solve नहीं करता क्योंकि data इतना close दिया हुआ है ना कि मैं approximation के साथ जाऊँगा तो मुझे पता है गलती हो ही जाएगी मुझे exact value निकालना पड़ेगा और exact में it will take some time. Because the calculation is very lengthy. That's why ये question आने के बाद भी मुझे इस क्वेश्चन को छोड़ना पड़ता आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू राइट बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि मतलब मन में दुख रखना पड़ता कितनी बार मेरे साथ भी हुआ था देर विल बी द फाइव देर विल द वन क्वेश्चन ऑफ द फाइव वेरिएबल राइट देर विल द वन क्वेश्चन ऑफ द फाइव वेरिएबल आई नो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सॉल्व दैट क्वेश्चन इट विल टेक मोर देन 2 मिनट आई नो दैट राइट सो आई लेफ्ट दैट क्वेश्चन एंड आफ्टर द सॉल्विंग द एंटायर पेपर मुझे लगा कि अगर मैं पूरा सॉल्व कर लूंगा उसके बाद आके मैं उसको सॉल्व करूंगा पर मुझे टाइम ही नहीं मिला उसको देखने के लिए पर डेफिनेटली अगर मैं उस क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करता डेफिनेटली आई लूज सम क्वेश्चन राइट सो सेलेक्ट करना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है अप्रोक्सीमेटली माइल राइट सो द आंसर विल बी 0.64 इफ यू सॉल्व इट ए यस यस हर्षित करेक्ट आंसर विल बी 0.64 व्हाट द करेक्ट आंसर नाउ इफ यू सॉल्व Now, if we are moving on the next question. A satellite system employs QPSK. Okay, just remember one thing. For the satellite communication also, whenever the bandwidth formula is required, just use this formula, 1 plus alpha upon log 2 base of m. That is called PCM. It is the formula for PCM. And alpha is nothing, it is what? ये मैंने पहले भी लिखवाया हुआ आप लोगों को communication का, जब आप देखोगे तो उसके अंदर yes Anshita, 1 mile equal to 1.6, yes, लगभग 1.5 किलोमीटर के आसपास रहता है, that is 1.6 किलोमीटर, correct. Now alpha is nothing, it is just a what? Roll of factor. Or here the roll of factor is given 40% of excess bandwidth. So for the 40% of excess bandwidth, alpha is given in the problem 0.4. Right, just solve this question, everybody. Very easy question, that is not tough question. Just solve this question. Alpha is roll of factor, yes, assure you. Alpha is a roll of factor. Surendra, A option. Surendra, kiska answer de rahe ho aap? Just solve this question, everybody. RB is given directly. What is the bit rate? 64K. Okay, what is the question? A satellite communication employ QPSK modulation with 40% access bandwidth per carrier including guard band. The voice channel use 64 kbps. It is a what? RB is given in the problem. Bit rate. PCM coding. The number of the channel supported by the 36 megahertz bandwidth of the transponder in the bandwidth limited case. Okay. They are asking something different, that is not asking related to only bandwidth. This bandwidth is much higher than this bandwidth. So how many number of channels are required? Yes, Ram Swarup, your answer is correct. 800 is the correct option. How we'll get? Just find out the bandwidth for this. Just use the formula. What about the RB? RB is given 64. 64K, 1 plus 0.4 upon log 2 base of, what about, what type, that is called what? QPSK. It means M is equal to 4. So if you want to solve it, the bandwidth for this particular question will become 44.8 kilohertz. 44.8 kilohertz is the answer is coming from this. Now that is not an answer. It is not an answer. Actually, the number of channel is required for supported for this. So for the PCM, it is required this bandwidth. And if you want to number of channel supported, then it will be 36,000, I am writing in kilohertz, it is also in kilohertz, dividing by 44.8, it will give you approximately 800. So answer will be what? B option is the correct. Yes, Rajat Jain, 803.57, correct. Rajat, your answer is correct. Harshit, your answer is correct. Surendra, your answer is correct. Ram Swarup, your answer is correct. Yes, 44.8. Yes, Ashray, correct answer. Samira, your answer is also correct. Bahut hi badhiya. Everybody is giving the correct answer. How to solve log values easily? Okay, for the log value, just remember two or four things. Log 2 base, right? On that log, sorry, log 10 base of 2, log 10 base of 4, log 10 base of 3 also, log 10 base of 5 and log 10 base of, right, this one from the log 10, right, this thing remember, and for log 2 base also just remember this one. Ye maine communication ke time mein bhi aapko bataya hua hai. In the communication I have given that data, right. Akshay, answer is correct. Mrunal Dev, answer bahut hi sahi hai aapka, bahut badhiya. Now for the next question, a satellite communication link has uplink. देखो वही पर वही क्वेश्चन, और ये खुद बनाया हुआ क्वेश्चन नहीं है, दैट इज द इसरो क्वेश्चन. ये इसरो में आया हुआ क्वेश्चन है, राइट. सो अ सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन लिंक हैज अपलिंक सी बाय एन नॉट इक्वल टू 50 dB पर हर्ज, डाउन लिंक सी 47 dB पर हर्ज, वॉट विल बी द ओवरऑल लिंक. डू यू रिमेंबर द फॉर्मूला एवरीबडी? जस्ट गिव मी द आंसर. कैन यू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन और डू यू हैव एनी डाउट? कैन आई मूव ऑन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन? 50 dB means just convert it dB to the normal value, 10 raised to power 5, 10 raised to power 4.7. And now solve it. C by N overall equal to, multiply this one, 10 raised to power 5 into 10 raised to power what? into 10 raised to power 4.7 upon 10 raised to power 5 plus 10 raised to power 4.7. It is the normal value, just convert into the dB. If you will convert into the dB, you will get what? 45, correct. Correct, Suruchi, correct. Samira, just give me the answer for this. Swaroop, 44. Actually, the answer will be 45.23 dB. The answer will be what? 45. In the dB, if you want to find out, that is 45.23 dB. Answer will be 45 for this question. The answer will be 45. Yes. Vikram, correct. Shiva, correct. Mani, correct. Samira, correct. Shavgi, girl, correct. 45. Vikram, correct. Mrunal, correct. Balu, correct. Ram Swaroop, correct. Harshit, that is 45, not 44, right? 45.23 dB. Okay, just solve this question once more. One more question. A signal transmitted from an earth station bounced back from the geostationary satellite with the altitude of 35864 km from the earth surface. The range from the earth station to the earth station is 38200 km. The round trip time is about, we have to calculate the round trip time. That is very easy formula. How to calculate the time? Time is nothing, it is just a distance upon velocity. We have to calculate only the distance. Velocity is nothing, it is just a what? Speed of light. 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. Just solve it. Very easy question. So I am writing T equal to round trip time. Sorry, round trip. Round trip, it means the distance is actually the doubled. So round trip distance upon what? Velocity. So what is the distance is given in the problem? What is the basic distance? 38. Actually distance dono ke beech mein ye hai. Wo to bounce off ho gaya. Wo to alag cheez hai. Distance diya hua 38200. That is the from the distance only. But we have to find out the round trip na. So we have to multiply by 2. Dono time nikal ke a jayega. Divide by, yes, correct answer. Suruchi, correct answer. Excellent. And what about the velocity? 3 into 10 raised to power 8. So the answer will be what? 255. Very good. Shiva Prasad. No. Shiva Prasad, that is 255 millisecond. Yes, 1 is correct answer. Vikram. 255 millisecond. Approximately. Yes. Prakash, correct. A option is correct. Harshit, A option is correct. Everybody, Suruchi, your answer is correct. Now, one question will be given as a homework to you, right? So again, for the repetition, I am just giving you one brief idea. Just remember EIRP. Just remember the formula GR. Just remember the formula LE. Just remember the formula AE. Just remember the formula PR. Just remember the formula C by N. Right? This one is important for you. Right? And one question I am giving you. Yes. Ashwari, your answer is correct. Rudra. Bahut dino baad, Rudra. Bahut dino baad dikh rahe ho. Answer correct. Rudra, your answer is correct. Yes. One question is a homework to you. I am giving you the answer here, the answer for this. 0 dBm. I am giving you the answer. Just solve this question. Sir, how to distribute the time between the IS and ISRO? Dekho, for the IS and ISRO. IS on the paper 1, ISRO on the 12, right? So, iske andar aap dekho, abhi aaj kya tarikh ho gayi? There will be the 22. So just remember one thing, for the 5, aapke paas ISRO ke liye kitne din bach gaye hain, aapke paas total there will be the 7 days, right? So ek do topic ya ek do jo chote chote subject hai, you can prepare between these time, right? Otherwise for the IES, just cover the syllabus, kyunki IES ke liye bhi jo paper objective aap question dene wale ho, solve karoge. That is not different from the ISRO, that is the syllabus is almost same. For this particular. So, आपको ज़्यादा कुछ दिक्कत करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. बस ये analysis आपको करना है कि किस तरीके से question, कौन सा topic आपका weak है और कौन सा topic आपका strong है, right? Strong topic को revision में रखिए. और जो टॉपिक आपका वीक है कॉमन वाले पोर्शन में उसको ईएस से पहले पहले कवर कर लीजिए. और जब आपके पास 30 के बाद, आफ्टर द 30, डू नॉट टच एनीथिंग, जस्ट रिवाइज. डू नॉट टच एनीथिंग, जस्ट रिवाइज, राइट. बाकी का ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट. नेक्स्ट क्लास में हम मिलेंगे विद अ राडार, और होप आप लोगों ने क्लास को एंजॉय किया होगा. एंड यस, शिवा प्रसाद, यू आंसर इज करेक्ट, द ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. होप आप लोगों ने एंजॉय किया होगा, और नेक्स्ट क्लास में आप राडार से रिलेटेड और क्या क्या चीज़ें चाहते हैं वो आप कमेंट के थ्रू आप इसको बता सकते हैं इसके अंदर, और नेक्स्ट सेशन के अंदर भी आप क्या क्या इंप्रूवमेंट चाहते हैं उसको भी आप कमेंट के थ्रू आप बता सकते हैं. विल डेफिनेटली गिव यू दैट टॉपिक, राइट. टिल दैट, थैंक यू वेरी मच, ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट, राइट.